Hey everybody, welcome to the Sorting Hat Podcast. I, as always, am your host, Michael Barryte, joined by my co-host, Katie Reed.
I'm here.
You are indeed. And today we are joined by the wonderful Monica Vasandani, a writer for Smosh and UCB Maude in Los Angeles.
Hello.
Hello.
I have to burp.
Okay, you're welcome to burp if you want to get that burp out now.
No, I got burp right now. It went back.
Yeah, you got self-conscious about
it. Let's see if I can work one up. I'll just boil it in my tummy real quick.
And on the Sorting Hat Podcast, we sort all the things into the various houses of Hogwarts, as we believe that everything and anything can be sorted. I am a Ravenclaw, Katie is a Hufflepuff, and Monica, you are...
I'm a Gryffindor.
You're a Gryffindor.
Surprisingly.
Which... knowing you as long as I have, I am slightly surprised by that.
Were those older Weasley brothers, the ones who are twins, were they Gryffindors?
They're all Gryffindors. They're all,
yeah, you're in that like mischief. You're like in that mischief crew.
Yeah, I got that Slytherin front, but I'm a Slytherin in the streets and a Gryffindor in the sheets, which is not what you want.
No, you want it, if anything, to be the reverse.
Right.
Like, you really probably want Slytherin in the sheets in any scenario. So, like, Ravenclaw or Hufflepuff on the streets and Slytherin in the sheets.
Yeah.
Nobody ever wants a Hufflepuff in the sheets. I can accept this. I
mean, unless you, like, all you want to do in the sheets is, like, eat a good snack and, like, cuddle.
Yeah. No, I think Hufflepuffs probably are the best cuddlers.
Yeah.
And I bet they have
the sheets
like
are probably
real nice
nicer
blankets.
Too.
Yeah. Oh yeah. For sure.
Yeah. And so on this particular episode, Monica has requested that we sort women's pants.
Yep.
Oh, great.
And so we are diving on into this. It is also worth noting that you went to FITM for.
Yeah, I went to fashion school.
Whoa.
And. How many years of fashion school is like expected, required?
The normal amount is 2. I went for 4.
Mm-hmm. So you're deeply entrenched in the world of fashion.
I am so into zippers, dude.
Well, what's your favorite zipper fact?
It's not a fact. I do have a favorite zipper brand though, which is Riri, R-I-R-I. I think they're like Swedish or something. Someone's going to have to check me on that.
Yes. Oh, wow.
They're great zippers, dude.
Is it the teeth?
It's all of it. It's the pull. It's the teeth. It's the look.
All right. Well, that is very good. So we're in some degree dealing with that, as some pants at least have zippers. Other
Riri,
time
hit
button.
Us up for a sponsorship.
But we'll just dive straight on into it. You were very kind and made up a list of sort of. A breakdown of sorts, because I am not so fashion forward.
Get out of here.
I don't believe you.
Get out of your seat. Leave the room.
Yeah, can you leave?
Leave the building. Get out of here.
All right.
All right, well, I hope you guys enjoyed the podcast.
Yeah, well, I shouldn't have been. Bye, Michael.
Michael's just standing in the closet. I'll let you know when he's out.
It was weird in the closet there. All right, so we're back. And you made up a nice list for me. So, and we've also got this wonderful vocabulary fashion guide from the Ultimate Trousers or some website
Ultimate
that you pulled
Trousers
up.
Hit us up for a sponsorship.
Put in that code Ultimate Trousers for 5% off your trousers.
Yep. Sponsorship deals that don't exist from us. So, starting off, you put jeans with the category or like subsets of straight, skinny, boot cut, and flare all being together.
Well, those are different cuts of jeans.
Those are different cuts of jeans.
You looked overwhelmed. You were like, how can they all be the same?
Yeah.
It's weird to me that your knowledge is that limited, because like jeans are the most basic.
Oh, no, trust me.
Ooh,
I wish I had a better understanding of jeans, because I definitely, every time I go to shop for jeans, it is the same weird struggle where I'm like, I know I don't want it flared out at the bottom, and I don't know what that means, And then it's me trying on every set and knowing also that I don't like skinny, but like I don't mind them being that tight. You've seen the things I wear.
You got that butt on parade.
Yeah, you do kind of have a booty.
Thank you.
Yeah. You're welcome.
I feel slightly objectified in this moment. So, all right, within jeans, uh-huh. Do you feel of the four that I've read off, straight, skinny, bootcut, flare, there is a definitive Gryffindor, Ravenclaw, Hufflepuff, or Slytherin?
So this is all umbrella together, all of these cuts.
No. Ooh, if you feel that one stands out as like more, we're now just dealing in jeans.
I think skinny jeans are Slytherins.
Mm-hmm.
Because like they're very unforgiving. You'll like see all of your leg flaws in a skinny jean.
Mm-hmm.
They're tight. They like hold you in.
Mm-hmm.
Constricting like a boa.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Constrictor.
Well, and they're definitely going to not only restrict as far as once you're wearing them, but also like it's a struggle just to kind of get there, which is like already going to be pushing people away.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And then if you put something in your pocket, you don't get it back because you can't reach your whole hand in there. So like if it's something small, you can maybe get like up to like the second knuckle into the pocket. But once it's gone down like 3 to 4 inches, that item is lost forever.
Right. The pockets are the chamber of secrets of your pants.
Yes.
However, sometimes weak-hearted individuals may be tempted by the skinny jeans. Say if you are a gentleman under 5'3", like myself, you can't wear the longer pants without taking them to a tailor. So you get the skinny jeans hoping that you can just bypass the entire problem, or otherwise you end up like with your cuffs like dragging past your foot, and then you fuck up your jeans on the bottom. I'm not saying that anyone in this room suffers from that problem. I'm a strapping lad myself. But if you did, you might be tempted by skinny jeans.
Is it also worth noting, and maybe it's just I do associate skinny jeans a little bit with like the a little more as like fashiony, like and like
yeah, like they're
and there's like a sex
more,
appeal,
yeah,
which I think Slytherin does carry of like just being the bad boy jeans.
Yeah, yeah, they get down, you know.
Right,
skinny jeans like to fuck.
Right,
this pant fucks.
So I don't think there's any debate that skinny jeans are Slytherin.
Yeah,
moving over to boot cut.
My instinct would be they're Gryffindors because they're kind of like cowboys.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I would say that the straight leg is more of a cowboy.
Oh, really?
Thing. Yeah, because the boot cut is like it's pretty much a flare, but it's just a flare lower on the leg.
Mm-hmm.
So boot cut and flare are pretty similar, but I think the Gryffindor in the pack is the straight leg.
Oh, gotcha.
I was kind of feeling that the straight and boot cut might fall in as Ravenclaw.
Oh, because they're kind of just like straightforward. And
yeah, they're fairly vanilla. Like they're not like flare is going a little further than boot cut. Mm-hmm. Right. And I feel that I'm a little torn on flare, as I feel it could go Gryffindor in the fact that it's like a bolder move.
Yes.
But at the same time, it could also be Hufflepuff.
Right, right. Like there's plenty of room for your legs. They're mm-hmm. probably very comfy and very easy to just kind of move around in. That's probably a daytime to evening thing. You know, you can just wear the same pair of pants all day instead of changing them.
I definitely wear pants all the way through the day.
So you wear your day pants at night?
What?
I didn't know that there was a day pants, night pants situation. Am I
Good God.
A disgusting individual now?
Yeah.
Well, things that I'm learning on this podcast outside of my crippling singledom, which Katie brings up every episode.
Slide into the DMs as easily as you will slide into his evening pants.
Which are non-existent.
Aww. But they could be if you slide into his DMs.
good save.
We'll get him some evening pants. It'll be a perfect date.
Yes.
I forgot to ask, how many people listen to this podcast?
Who knows?
You've never
Everybody's
checked.
Everybody's mom.
All right.
Yeah.
Your mom probably listens to it and you don't even know yet.
Now, based on the answer that I were to have given you, would you have then like monitored your words a little more closely?
No, I just wanted to know if it was like enough people for me to say hello to them individually. Or if it was more than that.
I'd like to believe that it's more than that, but we've also held back on shouting out yet as hopes of building out like a larger breadth of episodes before we declare this to the world. But this is all discussions happening on air right now. So, you know, moving on, because I think we've sort of sorted.
Yeah. Yeah.
As far as jeans go.
Mm-hmm.
On to leggings, which you have stated include stirrup and regular.
Yeah, I didn't know what to call them because there's like just the regular leggings.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Which honestly, I don't think leggings are pants. Some people think leggings are pants.
So if somebody's wearing just like a blouse and leggings, you're like, no, that's not a complete outfit.
No, I don't think so. It's like, it feels wrong to like see the outline of somebody's vagina.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
So in the case of somebody wearing leggings, you're like, you need a skirt or dress over that.
Or there's like new leggings that are like athleisure leggings,
mm-hmm.
Which is, it's basically you can wear them when you're performing feats of athleticism or when you're just doing leisure time.
Mm-hmm.
And I guess that seems like a Ravenclaw to me.
Like those specific leggings.
Yes. Yeah. I think Kate Hudson makes them. You can look them up.
Mm-hmm.
Kate Hudson Fabletics. Shout out to our sponsor.
Right.
Go to the website and put in the code sorting for 20% off of one pair of leggings.
Those Fabletic leggings available from Kate Hudson.
Mm-hmm.
So.
And then the stirrup ones are the ones that have the thingy that go under your foot.
They hook under the heel.
Yeah, so that they don't ride up on you.
When I was growing up, only ever did I see them on like substitute teachers.
Oh, those are a Hufflepuff, I think.
Yeah.
The stirrups?
Really? Ain't nobody's looking good or like not dorky, rather, in those.
I think that the stirrups actually serve like a very specific function and are like, oh, there's the problem that you always encounter with leggings.
But at what expense? This. At what price? You look like a nerd in them, is what we're saying.
How often are you're cavorting around in them and you're wearing shoes?
You're asking the wrong questioning practicality in the fashion world is a slippery slope very quickly.
Guys, I think I have women's. A pretty solid understanding of fashion. I watched The Devil Wears Prada and really liked it.
I think what you were getting at was that people wouldn't be able to tell that there's a stirrup there. Mm-hmm. You can tell.
Oh, is it because there's like stressing on the
yes, yeah,
around the and ankle? Also like invariably the wearer also has like Keds or what are those Croc shoes on, and so it's like the person who's going to invest in those stirrups, they're usually making bad choices otherwise in other places.
They're not they're not trying to hide their stirrups. Mm-mm. They are sporting them proudly.
Yeah,
mm.
You either love them or you hate them,
and I.
Everybody's talking about them.
I'm just learning a ton about all of this. That's the real takeaway. So you're feeling stirrups are Hufflepuff.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah, I agree.
But then regular a Ravenclaw? Or was the athletic one
the
Raven?
The athleisure.
The athleisure, sorry.
I would also say that, I would say regular leggings are Slytherins.
Regulars.
Because they have a lot in common with the skinny jean, but you go even further in, yes, their attempts to make you feel like really uncomfortable if you are the wearer, or uncomfortable if you are just the spectator of somebody else wearing them.
I can see that. I get that.
Yeah. Okay. I'm down with that.
Wow, we are rocketing through. I think also some of it's coming down to the fact that you provided a list that is far longer than anything I anticipated.
We can stop anytime.
No, man, we're rocketing through all of these.
How
next
long
up,
are these episodes?
Next like, up, cargo pants.
Hour and 15. Ooh, oh, cargo pants.
All right, well, depends on what angle you're going at.
Yeah, although I think it is safe to say that they either land in the Hufflepuff or Ravenclaw camp.
For sure.
I think they are very like utilitarian.
Mm-hmm.
Like you get a lot of pockets out of those.
Right.
And you don't really care like how you present yourself.
Yeah.
Right.
Can I give a slight tangent and also
please.
So my brother, who I love dearly, is a devoted wearer of cargo pants. And his Monica just released a heavy sigh in case you didn't catch that on mic.
Quick question. Does he have the ones that unzip and turn into shorts?
No, no. Although my dad has had those.
Of course.
Yeah.
I think that when you're a dad, like as soon as the baby's born, you get a pair of them.
Right.
Yeah.
Like so, the hospital sends home the baby wrapped in those cargo pants with the zip off.
And now that I'm thinking about it, I'm not sure what house my brother is sorted into, but let me just give you his usual attire. It is cargo pants, steel-toed boots.
Oh.
Any like graphic tee that he probably acquired while he was at MIT, of just like from various clubs or whatever. Then a bowler hat, but not like a nice bowler hat. It's like one of those, oh, we were in theater class and we were doing a chorus line, so it's one of those like flimsy brimmed ones with the wraparound of like where the strap would be.
Monica looks
is
so upset right now.
Is a usually a purple bandana that's sort of wrapped around.
She's then like he's grabbing her face in anguish.
Hold on, it gets better. He crochets fingerless gloves for himself.
She looks like she's about to jump up and dart out of the room.
I am losing my damn mind right now.
The color on the fingerless gloves tend to vary based on what shirt he's wearing, but not always.
So he does put a lot of thought into this.
And then he tops it all off, usually with a trench coat.
Oh my God. I bet he looks like, does he look like an Alaskan bush?
It is also worth noting he has steampunk metallic goggles.
Oh my God. The craziest part is I bet he gets so much pussy. Does he get pussy?
These are things that we don't discuss.
Can you text him right now and ask him if he gets pussy?
He will not tell me. I can assure
Monica,
you.
My friend Monica from my podcast, I described her outfit and now she needs to know how much pussy you get.
Because like for every dude who looks like that, there is the like woman who looks like that too, mm-hmm, who's like all about that fucking those fingerless gloves and like the terrible hat that doesn't know if it's
what
like
those
a
little,
beanie
like,
or fedora.
What are those little tiny hats called? Like Mystifier or what is it called? It's like the tiny Victorian hats that they wear. And you're like, that's not actually covering your head.
Oh yeah, I have no idea.
She's wearing one of those right now and then uh-huh, the same fingerless gloves.
Yes.
I can see it.
I feel like you're describing like a character that Helena Bonham Carter.
Yes. Wore. Yes. Yeah. Yeah. Because she's
I
also
can see your brother with Helena Bonham Carter. I for mean, sure.
He does love Tim Burton.
Does he own a katana?
No.
Do you own a katana?
No.
Okay. I'm very surprised.
Really?
The odds are good that one or both of the Barryte brothers have katanas.
I hate blades. So.
What do you think he keeps in his cargo pants?
Oh, I know a handful of things that he keeps. Oh, he also has a utility belt.
Motherfucker, I can't.
Like, you two have to meet at some point. I think you have met him, but I don't think he was ever that upscale as far as like the full outfit on. Sometimes it's not a trench coat and sometimes it's just a hoodie, but we're like way off topic, but it is like playing cards, maybe like
does he do magic?
Yeah, in case he does magic.
He might have one of those contact juggling balls.
Oh my god. This is made up.
No, my brother is 100% real.
Oh man.
He's amazing.
He's fantastic, but like honestly, I need to ask him what Pottermore sorted him, because I know he's not a Slytherin, but he could very easily fall into Gryffindor, Ravenclaw, or Hufflepuff, and I would be like, yeah, no, that makes 100% sense, despite the fact that there's a 33% split on what I feel that you could be.
No, he's definitely a switch hitter for sure.
Anyway, cargo pants.
Oh, man.
Honestly, like, my only instinct to put them into Ravenclaw is the only time that I'm ever okay with a person wearing cargo shorts or cargo pants is if you are an actual scientist. If you need to wear them for your work, then I think that they look good and you have dignity. But if you don't, if it's the only place where your Yu-Gi-Oh cards can go, then no, I don't want to see you wearing them, and you are Hufflepuff as hell.
But I think cargo pants could go Gryffindor too, because if you are like an outdoors person and mm-hmm. you're like you're building shit, like they are, you would use them to like carry all the things you use to save people.
Would we put like the average paleontologist or archaeologist into Gryffindor or Ravenclaw? That would help me understand. That would help me decide.
I think that the average one would go into Ravenclaw. Yeah. But then you've got the ones who were like, yeah, I like just, you know,
the ones who go above and beyond and throw them. Most scientists, I feel, fall into Ravenclaw. But then you've got the like volcanologists or what have you who are like, let's go inside an active volcano, and you're like, all right guys.
Yeah, and then there's like deep sea divers who are like, nobody's been in this like weird cave water, we don't know how low it goes.
Yeah, and the last person who tried to do it died.
So maybe I'm going to try to find his body. You know what that dude wears when he gets out of the wetsuit is some cargo pants.
Right. Yeah. But I think we're sort of creating an exception to the rule mm-hmm. of it, where I think from a pragmatic standpoint, it skews Ravenclaw. I don't think it goes far enough to be Gryffindor. Sure. But at the same time, also just going off of like tool carrying, I think like a tool belt is more often than not more practical than like the pants pockets usually on cargo pants.
Mm-hmm. Sure. Yeah. Cause they weigh you down.
Yeah. They weigh you down. They slow you down. Whereas if you've got the belt is also a little more accessible, cause you've always got the person in like the lower set of pockets where you're trying to grab something from it and you do the weird lean down you're reaching, which only then supports further that they might be Hufflepuff.
Yeah, see, maybe I think cargo pants showed up and they're like, we are Ravenclaw pants. Like, right. We know who we're for.
They
we know
thought
what
that they
we,
were Ravenclaw.
And then Hufflepuff just like snatched them up and we're like, no, we're going to fill the pockets with like caramels or something.
Yeah. No, that's it. I think the intention was Ravenclaw, but they landed squarely in Hufflepuff.
Oh, no, yeah.
So sorry, cargo pants. Moving on to hot pants or short shorts.
Yeah.
Also, how mm-hmm. frequently, like, I tend to associate, I don't necessarily see cargo pants. Well, we said this was more women's fashion.
Yes.
But I don't think I've, how often are cargo pants really incorporated in the fashion world for women?
It rises and falls.
Okay. Like, I happen to miss the wave.
Yeah, so when Destiny's Child Survivor came out, the camo mm-hmm. cargo pants right. were real big. And since then, they've just been kind of ebbing and flowing.
Mm-hmm.
They're kind of big with like some hikers.
Mm-hmm. Right.
But definitely like mom hikers, not like badass ones.
Yeah,
not that moms can't be badass.
Not those
but
cool independent women hikers.
Right. All right. Jumping onto hot pants or short shorts. I don't have any.
Gryffindor.
Gryffindor?
Listen. You have to be bold.
Yes.
You have to have zero fear and know you're taking a risk. And there's a bit of pride involved mm-hmm. that I feel like a Hufflepuff. So I know we're narrowing it down to Slytherin or Gryffindor. But honestly, I think a Slytherin, while prideful, it would also be way too afraid of the potential clapback to risk it. Mm-hmm. Whereas a Gryffindor, getting criticized wouldn't matter because they know they look great.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think the hot pant is, I agree 100%. Like, it's a bold choice. And you know that you're going to be judged by some people and you're like, I don't care. It's it's 97 degrees out. I look good. I'm going to wear these.
Mm-hmm. I have to go dance in a cage right now. I do not have time for you.
What scenario is that? You have to dance in a cage, did you say?
Have you ever gone to a club? I'd like to know what it's like. I imagine people dancing in cages there, maybe caves.
I was thinking animal shelter.
Mm, okay, okay.
No, I was talking about like a go-go dancer.
Yeah, you know that animal shelter themed club?
Right, yeah, yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. Where you leave with both someone who you'll be sleeping with and then somebody who will be sleeping at the foot of your bed.
It's just called mm-hmm. bitch.
Which might be the same person.
Yeah, yeah. I sleep at the foot of the bed with the dogs.
Right.
Albertine sleeps diagonally across the bed.
Diagonal sleeper. Mm-hmm. Oh, that must be so tough.
Not for her.
Right, not for her. And you're just like, oh, well, you're cute. Just since we're in the category of shorts, kind of, mm-hmm. where does the skort fall? Because I know that this was something when we first were even discussing you being on the podcast, you were like, I've got a few things that I want to talk about, and skorts are at the top of the list.
Okay, I think skorts are sneaky, dirty liars.
Oh, go off.
Because they are like, from the front, they're like, I'm a skirt, and from the back, they're like, I'm a short, and they're just two-faced. I don't like them.
Yeah, who knows what they're going to be next week?
So a skort, because this is literally something I'd never heard of until you mentioned it to me, is essentially shorts with the front facing facade of a skirt.
Yeah. So imagine a shorts mm-hmm. and along like the left or right side, there's a panel that comes out in front of it and then it clips to the other side. Mm-hmm. So it presents as a skirt,
mm-hmm.
but from the back. And sometimes I think it'll go all the way around, but usually the back is just a regular shorts.
Is the benefit there for the sole purpose of sitting down? Because I have to assume that a skirt when sitting, as I wore a kilt when I was like 8, but I have no memory of I have to assume there's, when you sit, the skirt, like you've got to.
Your pussy doesn't your touch the chair.
No. I'm not so much concerned about that. I'm just wondering like fabric folds or anything like that.
I think skorts were made for school uniforms originally.
I can see that.
Yeah. Some good old Catholic guilt is involved.
Yeah, because they were like, you know what? These long plaid skirts, those are too racy. We got to put a short back on them. But because I think skorts are so sneaky and conniving, those are a Slytherin for me.
No other house would deceive you in such a way.
I mean, I think that I see it as either a Hufflepuff or a Ravenclaw purely on the fact of, or the perception, this is me like coming at it from the practical standpoint of like, oh, we're trying to be both like modest but fashionable in like people like skirts, but then also like we don't want it too racy, but it also comes off as just doofy as far as like it didn't make a choice.
And what the doofiness might be, though, that we have to tie it back to is that I'm gonna make it like identity politics for a second here. Like, think about the person who would want their child, especially, to wear this. It's going to be a more conservative parent who's like, I can't have my daughter wearing something as racy as a skirt. Then if some grown man gets a boner looking at her, that's her fault. But if I put her in a skirt that's also shorts underneath, then I can be doubly prepared that, like, when I send her out of the house, she isn't accidentally being sexualized by anybody. So I think, like, that is, like, it's like just like it's just like playing it safe on top of playing it safe, like having the practicality and also being like, don't. But we have to make sure everyone knows that you're a girl wearing a skirt and you have that dainty femininity to it. And that, oh, let me get off this soapbox right now.
So where does that land it?
Slytherin.
Okay, cool.
Okay, I won't argue in any direction, knowing as little as I do about this thing. As is a Bermuda.
Mm-hmm. That's a short.
It's also a short.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I'm just like, I'm trying to hit while we're in the category of shorts, I figure we'll tackle that too.
Yes. But, and you know what Bermuda shorts are, right?
Yeah. They kind of go knee high.
Yeah. They hit right above the knee.
I feel like if you're going to go yachting, it's a good option.
They tend to be a little more flowy.
Not necessarily.
You could have tighter ones. Yeah.
You could have a tight Bermuda, but it's basically the shorts that hit maybe like an inch or two above the knee.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of a mom short.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I feel that those are Ravenclaws. I think that they don't go so bold as like the hot pants.
Mm-hmm.
But are still granting you like, oh, it's a warmer day, so you're not going to cover your whole leg. Don't be crazy. But you're also going to be a little bit modest about
it. They're kind of like the Martha Stewart of pants options.
Because like they spent a little time in jail and are now friends with Snoop Dogg.
They're pretty, like, they're more fun than a regular pair of shorts. And then and also like, oh, I don't want to wear a full pair of pants on this nice summer day. Like, that's the sort of voice that I would.
I feel like Bermudas are fairly vanilla and like safe.
Yes. Yeah. Like you, it's seldom that you would see a Bermuda short with like a dark colored shoe.
Mm-hmm.
I always picture them with like white shoes and then like maybe a polo shirt. They seem like a good option for golfing.
Yeah.
They seem very practical to me.
Country club wear, man.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, do you feel any other direction than Ravenclaw on this, or?
I'm pretty Ravenclaw on it. I think Bermuda shorts are really practical. Like, maybe they put a little effort into being the best looking they can be, but they're practicality first.
Yeah.
Great. Then you have down here sailor pants.
Yeah.
What are sailor pants?
Okay.
Oh, I see them now. We have a little list. Sailor pants. Okay.
Do you want to read the description on
yes,
that?
Yes, I'll read the description. Sailor pants began as part of a work uniform worn by the Navy men. The bell bottoms are roomy and comfortable. On the front, they have a flap with buttons.
Yeah, so they're basically, I'm sure everyone's seen them. They're the high-waisted pants that have like two sets of parallel buttons, usually like 4 to 7 buttons on each side.
Mm-hmm.
And then the legs are just like hella wide.
Yeah.
Were these adapted into the disco scene?
For sure. Yeah. You'll see like probably pick up any Bee Gees album. One of those brothers is wearing a pair.
But for women, they've been adapted into like the Silver Lake scene recently because they're part of that wave of high-waisted pants that make butts look bad.
Yeah, because, like, this is definitely in the scene that, like, women have gone to, like, because for a while, the skinny jeans, like ruled the terrain on pants up until, like, a few years ago, it feels like. And then all of a sudden, there's been some sort of pushback to go back to high-waisted pants that, like, like you just never saw in like the early like 2000s.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And now we're like, we're going all the way up to like the bra line with these pants.
Yeah, but they really only work with certain body types.
Right.
Like you've got to be real skinny, and preferably kind of tall, but you've got to be like stick thin to pull off these pants.
Gotcha. Okay, so then from that perspective on how they are sort of to a specific type.
That's why Donald Duck, while a sailor, doesn't wear sailor pants.
Oh, because he's not so tall and limber?
And his butt's really big, so it's hard to pull off the pants.
I see. I see. He was thinking fashion first. I feel like this is a Slytherin.
Yeah.
Based on the high bar that you presented.
Right. Like they are all about purity.
And they're unforgiving.
And in my head, and maybe it also just comes from like my perception of how they would be adapted. I see it as a situation where they primarily are in like white.
White, navy. Which yeah, those sense. Are like the, I think you're thinking of like actual sailors. But they make them in denim, like they make jeans.
You'll find them in like a burnt orange or an avocado green on the aforementioned Silver Lake hipsters.
Gotcha. Okay. I wasn't sure if there was like a color specific to them, but in my head, I definitely see. Yeah. And they tend to be a little more flowy at the.
Yes.
At the,
yeah. Which tricks you because you're like. I'm comfy.
Right.
But then you have to be so skinny to wear those.
The fabric is, I'm sure, changed from a tougher sort of whatever the Navy had.
Actually, they're more like a denim or like a chino usually. They're not like a soft, stretchy fabric. They're woven, not knit.
Oh, I don't know the difference between those two things. So, you know,
if it stretches like a t-shirt, it's usually knit.
Gotcha.
If it's stiffer, like your jeans or like the shirt you're wearing right now with the button down shirt, those are wovens.
I see.
And it's just the way the fabric is made.
I'm learning so much and I'll forget this information tomorrow.
I'll call you tomorrow morning and tell you again.
Thank you, Monica.
You're welcome.
So we're in agreement that it's sailor pants are a Slytherin.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah. Okay. You're on board too.
They would destroy me
now
emotionally.
Just based on looking at these images as we're going through, I see that palazzos have a similar sort of flared bottom to
right,
them.
Right. That's a Cirque du Soleil sounding fucking pant right there.
So the palazzos are probably what you're thinking of. Those are like the soft, flowy.
Right.
Yeah,
and I realized as I said it, I was like, there was another type of pant on this form that I'm probably thinking of, but my mouth was already speaking, so I had to finish that sentence and look the part of the fool.
Oh, I did. Okay, now I just saw a picture of them. These goddamn pants. This is like, I'm going through my under the Tuscan sun sort of phase on. As like it's like very, very bohemian looking.
I definitely, for whatever reason, have like the imagery of what was it? Was it Nicole Kidman and Hugh Jackman who had that Australian desert movie?
I think it was just called Australia.
Australia, yeah.
Was there a horse involved? Because I might have seen the trailer if there was a horse involved.
But for some reason, I see it of like Nicole Kidman wearing palazzos and like a flowy scarf sort of thing.
Oh, something. Yeah. Something else needs to be flowing on you, whether it's your hair or like a grassy field.
I feel like the palazzos are the art house of pants.
What would you say is the flowiest house?
Who's got like the flow? It's probably like, that's the question of which house would be most likely to be caught with weed in it.
Which is Hufflepuff.
Yeah. And I think the palazzos are really like, it's not a looks thing. And that's something that you can wear kind of with any body type because contrary to like the sailor pants, which are really restricting on top.
Right.
The palazzo is pretty wide open all the way down. So I think that those are a Hufflepuff. Like they're comfy and they're flowy.
I think
good on your skin.
I think that the comfort thing is definitely within Hufflepuff's reign of wonderful.
Oh. Yeah. Yeah.
Terror or wonder. And for that very reason, I also do think that sweatpants fall into Hufflepuff.
Yeah, like Hufflepuff is the house most likely to move back in with their parents after college. So I can definitely see like going out in the sweatpants move being a Hufflepuff move.
Unless it's like the new wave of like the jogger sweatpants.
Mm. Oh yeah.
Which probably fall into Ravenclaw.
Yeah, because that seems really practical to be like, I want to be comfortable and I want to look good.
Right.
Yeah, I would say that joggers would be a Ravenclaw.
In the same sense, harem?
Okay, so harem pants are kind of like palazzo pants, except they have elastic around the ankle, so they come in. Sometimes they are drop crotch.
Jasmine has on Aladdin.
Yeah.
Gotcha. Okay. Yes. So in many ways, the harem is a fusion between a palazzo and a sweatpant.
Yeah, like a fusion of a palazzo and a jogger specifically.
Yeah. Gotcha. It'll be the nicer materials. It's not like some Kirkland brand sweatpant variant.
I want to buy the Kirkland harem pants.
Oh.
Which.
Please make it.
Now is potentially a fun point of contention because we decided that the sweatpants, unless they're the jogger specific, or Hufflepuff, the jogger specific, or Ravenclaw, the palazzo or Hufflepuff, this is the in-between of the two.
Oh, I'm going to get crazy with you right now. Okay. I think the harem pants are a Gryffindor.
What the fuck, Monica?
Yeah, because they're bold, dude.
Yeah.
Like, if you're wearing harem pants, like, in your real life, then you're, like, a break dancer. You're like putting yourself out there.
So you're going the type of person most likely to wear harem pants.
Because the most famous person I remember during the height of like when it became like trendy for a second again was Justin Bieber would wear the harem pants out in real life. So but it's a fellow like Justin Bieber who may or may not be a douchebag, but you know, is very brave.
Right.
Either way.
So that's sort of interesting that the fusion of a Ravenclaw and a Hufflepuff gets you a Gryffindor. I wonder if that is true for other types. We'll have to watch out for that in the future. And you, dear listener, keep track as well, because while we say we should watch out for that, we're going to forget.
So there is only one listener.
No, I'm hoping that there are a handful of listeners
and
some who are more devoted.
I'm assuming.
Robbie's
You took a shot in the dark on the one listener's name being Robbie.
Shout out to Robbie. Go on Robbie.com, enter offer code
Sorting Hat.
For 15% off your next podcast listener.
Wait, you get to
say what would Robbie be selling if not his listening abilities?
So hold on. So you're a podcast.
Yep.
You go to Robbie.com. You input the code Sorting Hat,
and you get 15% off your next podcast listener. I don't know what's so complicated about this.
I get it. I don't know what's wrong with your brain, Michael.
I clearly don't understand the ebb and flow of economics.
This is definitely one of those podcast commercials where like they're trying to come off like super casual about it, but they're hitting all those talking points.
Right. Like the fact that Robbie.com offers a wide array and assortment of different listenership.
You know what's great is they actually sent us a listener just to try it out. And I was like, this is whatever. It's just a free listener. And I love it. I use that thing every day.
Yeah, I have to say the versatility that you get from these listeners from Robbie.com, where you can enter the promo code Sorting Hat and save 15%. It's absolutely astonishing.
Yeah, all right, we hit it all.
Great. All right, moving back to the show.
Yeah, welcome back.
Wow, thanks so much for that totally unprompted and really well put together ad break. Do we want to? So we've knocked out most of them. Now there is at the bottom of this list the romper and jumpsuit.
Yeah, so the jumpsuit is the full length, and the romper is the shorts version, and that's basically like the one piece. They're pretty in right now.
Yeah.
it's basically, it can be a little tight. It can be a little loose. You can go anywhere with it. And
that's they all. Trick you. They trick you. They make you think they're going to be wonderful to wear. And then you go whole party and realize you have to go to the bathroom. And that's when you're fucked. I hate rot. Okay, I'm so, like, I would have transitioned into a masculine person just to get away from these outfits.
Yeah, I mean, you do have to get naked in a bathroom, which is
every
weird.
Time every time you want to go to the bathroom, if you're wearing a romper, you
or
almost
jumpsuit.
All, or jumpsuit. Jumpsuits might be easier, especially if you have, like, something else to wear, like, underneath it. But with a romper, you're taking that outfit off to go to the bathroom.
And with a lot of them, you go braless, so you are actually completely butt-ass naked in a public place.
Yeah.
Things that I didn't know about rompers.
They make you naked.
That, I mean, in some cases, that might be the best ad slogan for a romper.
But they trick you, and they are very flattering on most body types, especially, like you said, there's so much variation on, like, where it hits you or cuts off on angles.
So right. I've never seen a romper that looks flattering. I've seen jumpsuits look flattering mm-hmm. on people, but I've never seen any woman in a romper and been like, that is something you should be wearing.
Maybe it is just my circle of friends, but anytime I've seen a romper, it has always been a little bit looser. And anytime mm-hmm. I've seen a jumpsuit, it has been a little bit tighter.
Yes, but the looser jumpsuits are kind of... coming back.
I guess I always associate the loose jumpsuit with, we're at a costume party. And that was like... the only size that was available at the store.
Oh, the waist is still cinched.
Mm.
So it's not like a painter or something.
This might be too far back, but remember last VidCon, I had like that blue outfit that was like one piece. That was a romper.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. No, I was actually trying to think back to when you were like, when I wore a romper, I was like, why does Katie wear a romper?
Did it look
That's
bad?
About as feminine as of a clothing item as I could muster.
How did it look on you?
I think it looked fine, but I also felt like I was in drag anytime I tried to get feminine.
Right. Yeah,
so
I feel that.
I'm like, baby's good drag effort.
So where are we landing with this thing? I do think that perhaps the jumpsuit and romper might be separate.
Yeah,
but
I
then
would
also,
think so.
Also, just to throw another thing on there, do you feel that the jumpsuit and carpenter...
Well, the carpenter is the overalls.
Right. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah.
So those you feel are in two very separate camps.
Yes, because the jumpsuit is more like evening wear. And the overalls, I think, they used to be more utilitarian. Now they're like a fashion item, but it's still not like a nighttime fashion.
Right. In this situation, I understand the difference between daytime and nighttime. I recognize that a carpenter
you
is...
You almost never see overalls.
Last time I went to like a fancy ball, I didn't see anybody wearing a carpenter. No.
No.
Also was never at a fancy ball recently.
I put rompers in the Hufflepuff. If only because it's not necessarily the look that you go for when you're trying to be sex pot. It's definitely mm-hmm. more on like, I look cute today.
Oh, yeah, it's definitely like a cutie thing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So I would put the romper in a Hufflepuff, and I'd probably put the jumpsuit in Gryffindor.
Yeah, I could see that. Jumpsuits, actually, like, for some body types, like, if it works for your body, it works for your body. Like, you look... bomb in a jumpsuit. And honestly, most people who I think they work for actually a lot of body types. So I think it doesn't work
is when you don't have the confidence to pull it off. Because it's like a statement piece.
I think in a lot of cases in fashion, it does come down to confidence.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
But there are some that are more explicitly like, you're going to look like an asshole if you don't believe that you look better than everyone else in the room in this jumpsuit. Mm-hmm.
And then the carpenter, where are we landing on that? Just because I brought it up.
I'd probably put the carpenter into Hufflepuff.
Why is that?
Which makes me immediately believe that you have an alternate opinion there.
I'm curious. I'm still developing.
Yeah, okay.
I was like, which... which group is less likely to go to like a formal event and and not be underdressed in some capacity. And also just because I know a lot of Hufflepuffs also like working with the earth and with their hands.
That makes sense. Yeah, I could see that. And they're also the ones that people wear for fashion. If chances are, if you own a romper, you also own like boyfriend overalls that are like too big. And they're just like cutesy and loose and just kind of fun.
Yeah, I can understand that. That all seems to jive. Now, it's not on this list, but you had mentioned culottes.
Yeah, culottes.
I don't have any visual representation as to what that is. Does this fall into the category of pants, or is this just like something else?
Yeah, so culottes are a lot like palazzo pants, but they're shorter. Mm-hmm. And they were made... They were made when women started riding horses, not side saddle, but I don't know what you call it when your legs are spread on a horse.
Riding a horse.
Great. So culottes were made to look like skirts, but to have the functionality of a pant. And now I don't know who wears them.
I mean,
it seems like a weird choice.
I'm looking at them now, so I know what they are. They, I mean, I think it strikes a similar chord to you as the skort, then, based on the fact that it's sort of masquerading as two things.
Yeah, but the thing is with the culotte, it was so that women could do this like thing that was considered to be only for men,
right?
And to kind of get away with it. So I think there's like a female empowerment part of culottes that did not exist with the skort.
It's more of like it's like a Katharine Hepburn sort of move
reason,
of an outfit.
The reason I say that it might fall in the same category as the skort is just based on how like wide the legging is. Mm-hmm. Like if you look at it from a distance, you're like, oh, she's wearing a dress.
Yes. Cause it can definitely deceive you. Like there are definitely culottes, especially like with the way the materials used and the way that it moves. You'll think that from a distance you're seeing somebody just moving around in like a like maybe like an A-line like shin hitting sort of cut.
Which I feel because of that sort of trickery almost that it might be a Slytherin because of that.
I don't think it's malicious trickery though. No, I think that it's more of a Ravenclaw because it's like a
It's like one of those, like, nevertheless, I'm going to ride this horse.
It's being cunning and subversive about the way it's going about its change, which I think is, it's ambitious in what it's doing in looking to achieve its goals. So I think that in it is inherently Slytherin.
I mean, I just have good feelings about culottes, man. I think that it's... I go Ravenclaw, maybe even Gryffindor. Because
I would put it. Yeah, I'm saying since you guys are like saying that it's like both Ravenclaw and Slytherin, like wouldn't that then make it like a Gryffindor?
I suppose. Like I'm always just trying to fight the good fight for Slytherin because we don't have a representative.
As little as I know about Hermione Granger, Hermione would definitely be the sort of woman to wear a pair of culottes in her adult life.
Yes, because she would. She would still look. Hot as fuck. Oh, man. and she would just, like, hop on that horse.
And she wouldn't want to be doing it side saddle. She'd be like, I don't know. I don't have time for this. I'll go 15% faster if I ride it the regular way.
Gotcha. Okay.
So she would, like, enchant her skirt to become culottes.
I can concede that.
Yeah.
and on that, we've tackled all of the various categories of women's pant fashion, I believe.
Yeah, I think we've hit, I mean, not all of them, but we've hit like a lot of the big ones.
Are there any others that you'd like to tackle?
No.
No? All right. Very good. Then with that, I'd like to thank Monica Vasandani for joining us. We can see more from her as a writer on both at UCB's Maude Night every third Wednesday.
Yes.
The UCB
Sunset
Theater. Third Wednesday every month. And you're a writer for Smosh. And can we find you on Twitter?
Yes, at Monica Vass. I tweet once every 6 weeks, but they're all very good.
Yeah.
Great. You can follow Katie at that Katie Reed. You can follow me at Belated Media. Thank you so much for joining us on the Sorting Hat Podcast. Bye.
Bye.
Great.